Autocrat is a Google add-on to help you merge information from Google Slides, Docs, Sheets, and Forms into new formats like PDF. So you can use this to help you streamline the creation of documents that are similar but not quite identical. For example, you can use it to help you create certificates as each one is uniform in its look. However, they are all unique because of the name and the date that's printed on them. You can also use this for marking completion of professional development courses or to get in touch and share information to parents and students. So for today's example, I'm going to teach you guys how to use Autocrat with a fitness challenge certificate. So the idea is that I will send students a Google form after the event takes place. They'll fill out the form and then they will receive the certificate in their email. And me, I don't have to do any work of creating individual certificates for each and every person. So to get from here to there, we can go ahead and start with a Google Drive folder. You can create a new folder in your Google Drive by just clicking this new and then clicking new folder there. I already have one created here, and we want to create these folders because they're going to house all of the documents that are needed to work on this auto creation process. So first thing after you create your folder is to now make a template of your design of the document you want to share and send out to your students or to your audience. So I am going to use a Google Slide to create a certificate. So you guys can use Canva, you can use SlidesGo to help you get ideas and generate some creativity in creating your document. So we have a video linked up above with our favorite design tools that you can check out. Once your certificate is created and it's in Google Slides, we now need to edit it so that it's a template for everyone. So right now we have a name here, and to be able to pull for Autocrat to pull information from our Google form, which we will create next, we want to use these two arrows, and then you can type in the subject or a little tag for what information will be put there. So instead of the name there, I'll put that, and then instead of this event, I can just type event as well. And then I also want the date to be put in, as everyone might have a different date that they complete their fitness challenge. And then lastly, we'll just change this teacher so that it can be personalized as well. And that looks pretty good. So now our certificate and our template is all completed. So the next step is creating a Google form. So I do have one already started here in my folder already, so you guys can add in all of the information that you want to gather from your students to create this new document. You can even have extra information that isn't added as well. So as you can see here, I have the student name and their email address, their teacher, the fitness challenge that they completed, when they completed it, and these last two questions are just responses that I want to take a look at later. You'll notice that nothing really works in this certificate for those questions. So once your form is all filled out with the relevant information, up here in responses, you can go ahead and click create a spreadsheet. So this will make all of the responses be put into its own spreadsheet. So we can just go ahead and create a new one here. And this Google form will automatically be put into your Google Drive. So all those documents are stored in one place and it won't clutter up your Google Drive, which is very nice. So this form now has all of the questions as columns here. And now we need to use Autocrat. So Autocrat works within Google Slides, or Google Sheets, my bad. And in Google Sheets, you guys can go up into extensions and go to add-ons and then get add-ons. So you can search for Autocrat, but it's very popular. So usually it's right up here at the top, and then you can go ahead and install it. So once it is installed, you can go back up into your extensions and we can launch Autocrat. Once it's launched, we can go ahead and create a new job. So this new job will start that automatic creation process of our new document. So let's first go ahead and give it a name here. And then we can go ahead and click next. And the next step is to choose a template. So we're gonna wanna use that template from Google Slides, or if you use Google Docs, we can go ahead and pull that. So if you didn't create it beforehand like we did, you could go ahead and create an example here, but we're just gonna pull it from our Drive. So make sure you select the correct document and it will go ahead and then pull that in, and we can click next. And it's gonna fetch all of those tags that we put into our template. So everything that was surrounded by those two arrows, we now need to match to a column in our Google Sheets. So that way we know that in our certificate here, this name part, we want to match the column for student name. So that means when a student fills out the form and they put in their name here, that means their name will come right into here on their certificate. So we can go ahead and continue to match those with all of the tags and the columns that you guys put in. Last one here, we just have our date, and then we can go ahead and click next. So step four is for saving our file. So each certificate will be saved as its own separate file into that Google Drive folder. So to do that, first you need to choose how you want to save the file. So we can go ahead and if you click on this little arrow here, you'll see all of the tags. So we can go ahead and copy student name and paste it here and just type in our fitness cert. That way it's pretty easy to read and see whose certificate is whose in our Google Drive. So you can choose to keep it saved as a Google slide, or you can do a PDF. That way you don't have to worry about editing it later. So that is step four. And then we can go ahead and click next, and it should automatically pull in that folder if you started working from there to begin. But if not, you can go ahead and choose one in your Google Drive. If you don't choose a folder, it's just gonna save all over your Google Drive, which will really clutter it up. So definitely recommend putting it into that folder. That way it's also easier for you to find later. Okay, step number six, we can go ahead and skip, and step number seven. Step number seven is some options for you. If, you know, let's say the name wasn't filled out, then I don't want this automation to run. However, in our Google form, we have it set that students have to fill out their name before they can submit the form. So we can go ahead and skip this one as well. And now step eight is to share our document. So if you have younger students who don't have emails, you can choose not to share it, and you can go ahead and print them and share them on paper with your students later. But if they do have email, you can definitely go ahead and click yes to share and then choose how you want to share it. So it'll be shared as a PDF, and we don't really need them to reshare it, and we can send from our own email address. You can also choose to a no reply email address if you have a Google Apps account. So now we can set up our email that everyone will get. In addition, like how we saved these new documents, we can also use tags. So definitely in the to, we asked for our email address, so we can just type that in here. So whichever email they put into the form is the email that this certificate will be sent to. And then we can type in our subject. So we can also use our tags here. So let's go ahead and make it a little personal. We can use their name and say congrats. Now for the message. So we can start out a message here. We'll use their name again, and then we can just go ahead and type something real quick. And I'm gonna use another tag here. That way it also is a little bit more personal. We can mention the challenge that they completed. And that looks pretty good. So now our email is complete. We can go ahead and click next. And now we have to choose a trigger. So this trigger is meaning when that this automation from Autocrat will run and create those certificates. So you can choose to run on the form trigger. So that means that when the form is submitted, the automation from Autocrat will automatically run and the email will send with the new PDF certificate. However, if you don't want to do that on the form trigger, you can also do a time trigger. So this means that maybe a student will fill out the form at 9 a.m., but you have this automation set up to run every day at 5 p.m. So then they won't get their email and their PDF until 5 p.m. So either one works. Choose which is best for you, and then you can go ahead and save this automation. Once it's saved, you'll be able to, you can run it, you can edit it, you can view it, or you can delete it. And if you change your mind about the triggers, you can go ahead and manage the triggers right here and change it from the time to the form if needed. So that is all the creation process. So once you set up these kind of three different forms, you'll be able to send out that Google form to students and they'll be able to receive the document. So let's go ahead and test it out here. So let me grab this link and we can go ahead and open up a new tab to fill this out really quick. So once everything is filled out on your file here, we can go ahead and submit it. And then we should be able to go ahead and check our email and check out the process. So first, let's go ahead and take a look at our Google form to see the responses. So it is noted that we have a response here, and in our Google Sheet, you guys will see that the response was filled out. So all those steps are working correctly. And now if we go into our email, we see that we've gotten a new email with the correct name from those tags and the correct event that we put down. And then we can go ahead and take a peek at our certificate and see that everything looks nice. And that's all the steps on using AutoCrat to create and merge some information into new documents. You guys can use this for your own certificates, for sending out notices and updates and information to parents and students, or you can even use this to send out grades in a nice rubric format. Creating one template and then running AutoCrat to make all of the others will start saving you guys so much time. Thank you guys so much for watching. We do have more ideas on how to use AutoCrat linked down below for you to take a look at. In addition, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, turn on those notifications, give us a thumbs up, and leave us a comment below.